drive, and this is not where I shop at all. Question of the day is, how do I deal with being on oxygen and not being embarrassed? She's very young, and she just is having a really hard time with the whole vanity aspect of being on oxygen. Long story short, I am very vain, and I always have been, so I guess this is a good question for me. It took me a while to actually get over the whole vanity issue. All right, so we just have to flip the corner. Not flip the corner, I don't even know what that means. And don't hurt yourself on that tree. So long story short, after the critical care unit, I ended up at home, didn't understand the value of oxygen. My heart was beating out of my chest. So I watched a video, and that video was about rats. And in this video, they starved rats of oxygen for something like 3 weeks, and those rats developed pulmonary hypertension. And when I saw that video, honestly, everything changed, because I finally understood how incredibly serious it was to starve your body of oxygen. I had no idea. I had no idea that the lack of oxygen could actually cause pulmonary hypertension. So that video really changed everything for me. I started wearing my oxygen. And then another important thing for me to do was to turn my oxygen tank, and I feel weird even saying that and not addressing him by name, but it was for me to turn him into my friend, give him a name. I know I sound like I'm 6 years old, but it really does help. So we just have to cross the street. It's a little weird. Giving Steve his name, Steve Martin, made a big difference for me. And also designing him and making him look nice. He currently looks just a little bit feminine, but that's his style. He likes it that way. And my final point on this, and I think this might be the most important one, at least for me to remember, is that everybody has an insecurity. Everybody has something that they're dealing with. You know, some people are insecure about their nose. Some people are insecure about their height. Some people are insecure about their eyes. Everybody has something that essentially bothers them. I mean, I guess, unless you're one of those few that really doesn't have that. But generally speaking, people are insecure about something. Wearing oxygen is just one of those things. And maybe if you can look at it like that, that we all have something to deal with, that we're all essentially trying to deal with insecurity, and maybe oxygen is just, unfortunately, the insecurity that you have to deal with, and that I have to deal with, and I've become very comfortable with Steve now. So I was very insecure in the beginning, and now I've, you know, I kind of almost feel like he's not even there. Not to mention, dragging him up a hill will make your arm much stronger. So that's a perk right there. I really hope that helped. We're still on Rodeo Drive.
More than six minutes.
It's been over 6 minutes? Oh, we did it. All right, our 6 minute walk is over, everyone. And I'm still walking because we have to get back to the car. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you tomorrow.